Welcome to SSN, Sinclair Sports Network. I'm Jeff Price, the athletic director here at Sinclair Community College, and we have with us today Coach Gann, the women's volleyball coach. Coach Gann had a pretty good week. You started off playing a nationally ranked team, Columbus State, at home, and then you went up to Lakeland Community College, and you fared rather well up there. You went 3-1. So let's start off with Columbus State, your match at home with Columbus State.
Well, Columbus State is today, they're ranked 14 in the country.
Yes.
And it's a good team. And most probably they're going to be number one in the conference. And our team still struggling with our hitting percentage. So actually in the first game and the third game, we were very competitive.
Yes.
Unfortunately, they're much better than us, so we deserve to lose. But on the following day, we make some adjustment. Hopefully we can play much well in the tournament at Lakeland.
Yes.
And yes, we did play well. We came back with a 3-1 and one loss.
Yes.
And then I have changed the whole new lineup.
Yes.
With new setter and without practice.
Yeah.
So when we went there, the first set we played against Lake Michigan, it was my first practice. I told the kids, this is our practice, you know, see how good you are. And it was a scary one because they're a little bit confused.
Yeah.
The first set. And then we lost the first set to Lake Michigan.
Yes.
And then we came back the three set with very good score on that. So I think I'm glad. Oh, in average, you know, as I mentioned before last week, you know, our killing percentage was like less than 6%.
Yes.
And then this one averaged for four matches up in Lakeland. I think we bumped up to like 20 to 22% now.
Nice.
So that is always good to look for. I'm looking for at a 30% killing percentage. So hopefully these 2 day practices will still have to do a lot of adjustment to especially to polish out our weak point.
Right.
Especially on the blocking side and some other things that, you know, we're going to do. And hopefully when we play with Cincinnati State on Wednesday,
yes,
we can have another winning game.
Yes.
And move our percentage close to 30%.
Right.
That is my objective for the team.
That's been a recurring theme of yours since I've known you. You've talked about your hitting percentage throughout the time. And, you know, your first game and your third game against Columbus State was, I thought, had a lot of energy. You were close. You were right there. It was, you know, really up until about the 15, 16 point mark, until they kind of took a little bit of lead and you weren't able to overcome. Second game you alluded to that, you know, you didn't have a whole lot of, I don't think you had any kills that game. But coming into that, you know, you really were working on certain things. But to go to Lakeland, it seemed like going up there and you changed your lineup. Okay, you got some chemistry going, but there's also some team bonding. I saw that you guys were able to do some things, pull the ladies together. It's still a young team, and you're able to pull some games. Even though your record doesn't really quite reflect where you're going, you're 1-3 in the conference, tied for fifth right now, and you're 5-8. But where you started and where you're at right now seems to be where you're looking at. And tell us about the actual lineup change, because you mentioned to me that you were going to change the lineup, you know, after Wednesday's game, and then you went up to Lakeland and you sprung it on them. Walk us through that a little bit.
Well, Melissa Morales, who is my freshman, and I know she's a very good outside attacker, very smart one.
Mm-hmm.
I put her as a strong attacker in the beginning of the season. And in high school, she played as a setter and weak side.
Yes.
And actually, I didn't want her to set because I need a good attacking, attacker outside. And then Tiffany, you know, who's playing the weak side, and I need an attacker that really pound the ball and hit it hard. And somehow Melissa is not doing that for me. And same time, the second setter, Kendra.
Yeah.
And actually before, I already make up my mind to change the lineup and reshuffle the whole team together again. But before that, I talked to Melissa and Kendra to be sure what I think they were doing in high school. Because I did not have a chance to see them playing in high school, but saw them play in J.O. club.
Yeah. So, junior Olympic.
Yeah, junior club.
Yeah.
And Melissa, in high school, actually, she was a setter.
Yeah.
And Kendra wasn't a setter.
Yeah.
She was an outside and back row defense. So at this point, so I moved Melissa become a second setter.
Yeah.
And moved Tiffany become an outside attacker because she pounded the ball very hard.
Right.
And that's something you're going to scare your opponent away.
Right.
So, and at the same time, put Kindra as backdoor defense to play for Tiffany instead of setting. In that case, my setting is a better setting right now. Yeah. Not only that, when I line up, I start with a right front Claire, which is close to 6 foot, and then my middle close to 6 foot, and then my left side is Melissa, which is like 5 foot nine. So you have tall three players in front, is pretty intimidation.
Right.
So even they can play well or not, doesn't matter. It's they, intimidation.
Right, they pass the eye test. But watching the match and kind of wrapping things up here, you have a young lady, Carly. Carly Butler, she's ranked in the nation in digs per set. She seemed to be the spark, at least here. Did she continue that? And where does she rank at nationally right now?
Carly right now, she ranked number one in the country, and she has 7.5 dig per set. And one thing good about Carly is that she came from a long way, because last year she was so slow, she was so many things she had learned. I think she really appreciated that she learned a lot from me.
Yes.
Not because I have a good coach, because she's a good learner.
Yes.
Put that way. Right. And then she also keep herself very physically fit, and then she go faster. And let me put that way, everybody came over the net, even my blocker is not blocking well. She played very hard to be sure to pick up a rebound.
Yeah.
And it was very exciting. My daughter is a good volleyball player. She live up in Cleveland. My daughter came and watched a game, and after the game, she told Carly, there's few ball you think that was awesome.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, my daughter is 28 years old. She played a lot of volleyball. If she makes such a comment, simply mean this girl is doing her job. Well, I'm glad she continued to do that.
Right. Well, that's great. I mean, it was fun to watch her play, and then this is the second year, and we're obviously anxious. I mean, to have the number one ranked, person in the country at any stat is really amazing, and I know she'll continue to work under your coaching. You have three games this coming week. You play at Cincinnati State. Right now, Cincinnati State's 1-5 in the conference, and then you go back to Lakeland to play Lakeland on Friday. They're 2-2 in the conference, and then you finish up with Cuyahoga, who's 0-4. So this is a good week. You're 1-3. I know you want to make a big run in the conference. You're right there with the coaching changes. We wish you all the best of luck, and we look forward to talking about Cincy, Lakeland, and Cuyahoga next week. Coach?
Well, thanks a lot, and I hope we will play good and move up with our stack on killing percent.
Yeah.
And whole team play better, so hopefully we can win the three conference matches for my AD here.
Thank you. Good luck, and you'll be on the road, and they'll be back the following week to Sinclair. Come out to Building 8, watch the ladies play, and we appreciate you tuning in to SSN, Sinclair Sports Network.